Hello, this is Chad with SyncFusion, and a customer has a question about our Angular multi-select control. So let's get into it. And here's the actual customer question. They are using the multi-select drop-down box mode type, but they can't get it to stay. So whenever they are saving, or basically whenever the control loses focus, which is what they're saying here. Whenever the multi-select control loses focus, it loses the chips. They disappear. So let's take a look at our sample. Here's a sample. Now the customer did give us a code sample, and I can't show you that. So this is a slightly different sample that we sent back to the customer, but I'll still show you what was happening. Here is our multi-select. We have three multi-select controls on this page. And our multi-select has three different modes of operation: default, delimiter, and box. So here on our page, a couple things we've done. We have made six, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 different variables. And we're using those to define what these controls want to do. The first one has the dropdown, and that's here, the dropdown icon showing up. All the rest are doing what they should be doing. The placeholder is this, I'll show you, it's this text right here. That's your placeholder. So if you want to change whatever the default text here, you change the placeholder. And the way this works, our default mode, you're going to pick options, and as soon as this loses focus, it goes to comma delimited. And our delimiter mode does something similar, except it stays comma delimited the entire time. And then box mode, everything stays in a box. So you lose focus and you keep these chips. And this is actually what the customer wanted, was to keep these chips. So over here, where we define, we're in our component mode, you know, we're adding the control and all that. We define our data for this, we define our data set. Then we're going to define our fields. Our fields tell the control where the value is, where the text and the ID values are for that data. Our watermark is here, so if we change this to something else, then it all changes. Pick something. Now, this is where the customer was having problems. And we believe because box was lowercase. So now if we look at this, it'll do exactly what you expect. And as soon as it loses focus, it goes to default mode. If we make box capital, then it works like we expect. There it is. So that was what the customer was doing wrong. We think we solved it for him. We didn't hear back. Now, a couple other things about the multi-select control. These chips can be customized. And here's our public samples for you to come look at. These here, they're customized by color. So you pick something, shows up as that color. There's another way of customizing it is with a template. So here's a template, and this list actually has a picture, and it stays that way. So you can put these pictures in here. So these chips are very customizable. This is a pretty cool little control. It is just that easy to use it. And thanks for watching.